Welcome back. Returning to our lead story, and the raids in Sydney and Brisbane have raised awareness of the heightened state that Australia is now operating under, with Australian soldiers leaving for Iraq and the dramatic circumstances unfolding as a result of the raids today. There's been an increase in nervousness in the Australian Muslim community. Junaid Thorne is a Noongar man from Perth and a Muslim lecturer. A year ago, he was in hiding in Saudi Arabia, where his brother had been arrested on terrorism-related charges. Shayden Thorne was subsequently pardoned and returned to Australia earlier this year. Junaid Thorne has been lecturing at Islamic centres across Australia and is with Nitv News journalist Malarndirri McCarthy.
Thank you, Nat. Junaid Thorne, welcome to Nitv News.
Welcome. Nice to see you.
Now, the federal government has heightened the terror alert threat for Australia. Do you think Australia is at risk of a terrorist attack?
Well, Malarndirri, basically, and I think I speak for all Muslims when I say this, that, you know, as Muslims, we're peaceful people. We don't believe in violence. We don't encourage violence. Our religion actually, you know, is a peaceful religion, tells us to, and, you know, encourages us to be peaceful people. But what I think is that the government itself is the one that's posing threat to the community by picking on the Muslims and by targeting them in these new laws that they're about to, or that they're thinking of passing through. And I think that the raids that happened today here in Sydney and in Brisbane is just a, you know, a clear example of that.
The Australian government would say that it needs to step up the security of Australians, and that it's doing this because it has particular intelligence which sees there could possibly be some kind of threat within Australia. Isn't that an appropriate step for a government to do?
Well, if that was the case, then we're surely for that. I mean, everyone is concerned about, you know, the safety of Australia, and being an Australian citizen and being this my country, I mean, my rightful land. Of course, I'm concerned for the safety of Australia. But what sickens us is the hypocrisy and the double standard of the government. Where a few weeks ago there was one guy arrested in Brisbane, and he actually had, you know, bombs and explosives in his home, along with maps and other stuff. And we didn't see anyone coming out and talking about, you know, a terror threat, or about, you know, suspected terrorist attacks to be done by this guy or by whoever he was with. But now, you know, we see Muslims being arrested, one having a bow, one having a sword, one having normal stuff that maybe every, or like a lot of households in Australia have that. And here we have people coming out, or the New South Wales police officer, police commissioner, I think, or whoever, coming out and saying that Australia is under big attack, or is under big threat. I don't believe this, and I see that this is just another way to target and to attack Islam and Muslims.
But Junaid Thorne, do you think it's acceptable for Australians to travel overseas to fight with the Islamic State, given the images of beheadings and other things that we're seeing coming out from that region?
Look, personally, I can tell you that I don't support any, you know, specific group, and we're definitely, as a Muslim, I'm definitely against terrorism. But, you know, when the government is trying to pass down a law, it has to be just. I mean, it has to be fair. It cannot prevent Muslims from travelling overseas to protect or to help other Muslims, while it allows, for example, Israelis or Australians to go overseas and to fight with the IDF. That's clear double standards. And
so you're saying that in terms of religion, there should be that freedom of religion.
I'm just saying that you have to be fair. If you want to pass a law, you shouldn't, pass it down on a certain religion, and or a certain group of people, and not on the rest. And you have to be fair. I see this as, you know, discrimination and even racism, maybe, where you stop Muslims from doing what they may see as a religious duty. I mean, us as Muslims, we believe that, anyone that's oppressed, he has a right to stand up for himself. And as Muslims, we're one nation, we're one body, and we stand up for each other. So if someone wants to go and, you know, help his brothers overseas because he sees that they're being oppressed, why stop him? and not stop others that are going to fight for a Zionist state, for example.
But the Prime Minister has said that this is about stopping evil, that, you know, the actions of the beheadings of people that we've seen is what's ramped up the concerns of the government. You don't think that's a fair concern?
Well, again, I'll mention that Israel is, you know, bombing and killing innocent civilians. In its last attack against Gaza, thousands of children, women and, you know, innocent civilians have died. Also, let's not forget that Australia itself, it has a black history of beheading and massacres and, you know, genocide of the indigenous native people. So if Australia doesn't want to accept the fact that, you know, it has been itself barbaric, it doesn't want to condemn itself, and it doesn't want to condemn the Israeli state, for example, why, you know, pick and choose who to condemn and who not to?
So you support the Islamic State?
I'm not saying that. No, I'm not saying that. As I said, I don't support certain groups, but I do support the right for people to stand up against oppression.
Junaid,
and I think every dignified person, I mean, stands up for the same thing.
Junaid, what do you think about Australia sending the 600 troops to Iraq?
Well, I'll be honest with you, Malarndirri. If we look at recent terrorist attacks that happened in other countries, whether it be the US or the UK or other countries, I think the main reason for those attacks was that country's foreign policy and its, you know, invasion of Muslim lands. Therefore, I do fear that, you know, Australia, in doing so, it may be only, you know, increasing the likeliness of attacks on its own soil. Now, of course, that's something that we're against, and we're very concerned as Muslims. We don't want this to happen. And, you know, we understand that the repercussions of this will be very, very heavy, especially for us Muslims. But I see that Australia, in doing so, it's only, you know, like provoking the Muslims and maybe inciting them to do something wrong. And not only that, but...
What do you think the solution is here in terms of trying to make this a better place? What do you think the solution is here?
As I was coming here, I read an article about, I think it was released by the foreign minister herself or one of her staff members, in where they cut down the humanitarian aid to Iraq to zero from, it was a couple of $1 million, and this year they cut it down to zero. So if they were really, if the Australian government is really concerned about, you know, helping Iraq and offering humanitarian aid, I'm sure there are more better ways than, you know, sending jet fighters and troops.
All right. Junaid Thorne, we've run out of time. Thank you for taking the time to speak with NITV News.
You're welcome. Thank you very much.